Are you ready? We have...
Thank you.
just here to stop Rancor. He is the one responsible for launching the nuke at Sacktown and killing Blacklord. Rancor has been operating under orders from members of the NCR Congress. He's been deceiving us all.
We've seen the security footage of you and the courier leaving the nuclear facility shortly after the nuke launched from there. The atomic explosion could be seen in the distance as you two stood there and watched. I take it that you're admiring your handiwork. Pretty damning evidence, if you ask me. What evidence do you have to back up your claims? Nothing. I thought so. That's irrelevant. Made no difference to me. You wanted to avoid destroying the Liberator so it could be seized afterwards. Perhaps you wanted to make a statement. Maybe you just couldn't pass up the opportunity to launch a nuke. You and AJ are probably in cahoots with one another. There's a love interest between you two.
Stand by the courier all the way to the end.
The courier has shown he can be trusted. I owe him my life.
I'm probably going to regret this, but I'm siding with the courier.
The courier's got my support.
The courier's not afraid to face his opponents head on. I'd rather follow behind the courier.
I believe the courier can be trusted. I'll stand with him.
So you managed to gain a few loyalists. It makes no difference. They'll die along with you.
Courier, Rancor still has his first recon goons backing him, even with our allies. This is still going to be...
I got a few tank busters to make use of. How do you want to use them? I'll give them hell.
I can hack into the turrets laid out in the ship.
I'm no good in a fight, but I can hand you these supplies.
Thank you. command center is just...
It's time to roll out the big guns and blow these sons of bitches to...
Thank you. Weapons free.
lockdown. Let's get to the top deck, quick.
What's happening with everything?
The ship's been hacked! Navigation, weapon systems, defenses! I've lost control of it all!
You've got to be fucking kidding me!
Rancor, surrender now! It's over!
We still have the armor. It is too deathly, correct?
Yes, it's still online. I have the Seafinder right here.
Fire it on our position.
Say, what now?
Fire on the Liberator. Blast a hole through the hull of the ship. Do it now!
Have you lost your mind? That'll kill us all!
Rancor, stop! This is not how this has to end!
Fuck you! Fuck the NCR! Fuck the Legion! Fuck the whole goddamn world! If I'm going down, I'm taking everyone down with me!
Fuck, you lost it! Find some cover!
Thank you. can't believe it. All has been lost. My friends. All dead. My dig. I've lost everything! Rancor will never get away with this. I'll make sure of it, even if it kills me. What are we waiting for?
Any sudden movement and we'll blow you out of the sky! Identify yourself!
It's done. Rancor's... I've already radioed for someone to pick us... It's up to you. I trust you'll know what to do with it. I've just got word that Arizona is in flames. Nothing but smoke and ash for miles. I'm guessing you wiped them out. Good riddance, too. One less problem the wasteland has to deal with. A number of people made it to the escape pods. Some of them are still... Unfortunately, many didn't make it. When everyone at the airport packed everything into the Liberator and flew... So now, scabs have overrun the place. But I doubt that will last for long. I don't know. There's nothing here for me anymore. I just need to get away from here. Find a new place. I don't know. Wherever the... I guess you're right. Things will work out better if we stick together. Together, we are stronger. It gives us reason. In the end, that's what matters most. Sure, Courier. I'll follow alongside you. Keeping quiet.
Rancor screwed us over like this. I know General Blackthorn had his flaws, but he didn't deserve to die the way he did. We'll have to make do with what we still got. I won't abandon the frontier. I chose to come here with Blackthorn, so I'll... But our fight is no longer... Not to steal resources and force out the locals. Maybe then we can... Oh, before you go... I know it doesn't seem like much anymore. You've been an exceptional soldier.
Going to be a lot of work, but that's what I signed up for. I'm going to help turn this radio station into our new... Thank you. I hope you...
Shit!
Thank you. And so came to an end the courier's exploits in the frontier. With Rancor and Blackthorn dead and the NCR in complete disarray, much of the exiles disbanded. However, there were those who stayed behind. There were some who saw it as an opportunity to begin life as a vigilante peacekeeper, whilst others took the dark path and became the very thing they vowed to destroy. Whilst the airport was overrun by scavengers, they did not take up arms against the NCR civilians. Soon after, what remained of Goose Hollow became a town run by the scavs. It prospered, but would, on one fateful day, burn to the ground as Junkfleet's mayor sought to erase all traces of the exiles. Ashley Jane Terra, the only surviving member of the Wolf Pack, saw herself once again following a pack as she joined the courier on his march through the frontier. Though she wished for stillness, she found little comfort in the idle tidings of civilian life. After the courier returned to the Mojave, she found herself at a loss. She turned to peacekeeping efforts in a desperate attempt to keep herself above board. After the collapse of the exiles, Gray took it upon himself to try and rebuild. He took those still loyal to Blackthorn and formed a new splinter cell of the exiles. His efforts led to little success, as with no serious threats and no mission, the commanding officers became restless and wasted limited resources on gambling and other obscenities. Gray left the exiles in response. He burned his uniform and traveled to Junkfleet, where he spent the rest of his days trading and drinking. With Valerius dead and Ostia destroyed, the Northern Legion quickly disbanded. Most simply integrated into the native scab population, or used their fighting skill to form greater gangs. A choice few returned to the Legion Fort, where Caesar had them put to the cross for their failure. As the war subsided, Junkfleet began to prosper. No longer relying on selling information on factions, they were able to begin more legal operations. Utilizing Junkfleet's water reservoirs and ample space, large swaths of the underground were turned into hydroponic areas. Though the courier would never meet the mayor would eventually become a very powerful figure, albeit from the shadows. As the threat of the war passed, the mayor could no longer tolerate the slums' lawlessness. The guards moved through the slums like fire, arresting or executing the worst of the criminals. The slums would still be considered dangerous, but they would never again be as toxic as they once were. With no guardian to protect them, the Church of Eternal Life was quickly wiped out by violent outsiders in search of their treasure. Irvington continued to prosper, even as more and more people began to grow sick. After years of suffering and dozens dead, Dr. Pavas finally created a cure for the disease. With the plague ended, Irvington would grow to rival Junkfleet in size and influence, becoming a beacon of civilization in Portland. Salt Town continued to be prosperous, but some years after the war, mutated ants flooded out of the mine, destroying the town. Salt Town was soon abandoned, its ruins left to the ants. Thanks to the courier, Sanctuary was able to continue operating as a haven for sentient robots. Though Quentin would never admit it, his dealings with the courier had given him a new perspective on human-robot relations. Murder was no longer the first resort, and Sanctuary became open to outside trade. The secrets of the past were buried away. The Sanctuary embraced a bright new future. And so it came to an end, the courier's magnum opus, a final adventure to the unknown. The road to Hoover Dam now lay before the courier, an empty slate to be carved. Because war never changes.